there at the end, I could have got him back in there to end the half, but I wanted to, I thought that might, you know, be the time to rest him, knowing that I might have to play him the whole second half, being down 12. But we talked at halftime about deja vu, kind of, like this game was just like game four. We're down 12, we haven't played our best. We're trying to relax to you know, get back into it. And then that third quarter, we caught fire and we got to the small lineup, which helped with that. We didn't get to the small lineup in the first half. And so we kind of came early with the small lineup and they took us home.
When you make a decision like that, how much is planning that goes into it before the game? How much is just instinct that you feel the small lineup is going to give you the best chance of success?
Yeah, there's a little feel to this thing. It's not like, well, we're going to, you know, schedule them at a certain point, especially that we missed them in the first half. So we felt, as a staff, we talked about maybe going a little earlier with the small group and see how that works. And, you know, I thought we came out just like game four. We erased the lead. And then the small group again rebounded the ball and put us in a position, you know, to win the game on the road. It was almost surreal to the point where we're shooting free throws, and it was someone else this time, and JB makes one or two. But they got a great look. Quinn drew up a great play for the win, and we just got lucky.
Jason, this is a franchise that hadn't won a playoff series since you were playing point guard.
Thanks for making me feel old. It's a credit to that group in that locker room. They compete. They trust the game plan. They trust the coaching staff and the medical staff. But they do the work. And that group hasn't been talked about all year. We're not going to be a fancy group. We don't have a lot of big names. Luka is the one that gets majority of the attention. But JB, Dorian, and Reggie, and those guys really, truly, you know, believe in team. And that's what helped us win this series.
Did you think about the way Spencer kind of regrouped after, at times, it's been a tough series?
Yeah, you know, I think, Eddie, that we've had guys struggle, you know, and we don't really talk about the struggle. We talk about trust and knowing that they're going to get out of that struggle. And some will say it was his haircut, but he truly believed that he was going to have a good game for us in this series, and he picked a great one to have.
Jason, what was your message at halftime to the group? I mean, it was like a completely different team shooting wise that made you guys successful knocking down eight threes in the third quarter.
Yeah, we talked about, again, game four, being in this situation. But we talked about we were playing and nothing against Utah, but we were walking the ball up. We weren't being the aggressors. We weren't hitting first. That's what they were doing. They were desperate. They were hungry, and they were attacking us off the dribble. And so we talked about, you know, changing that. And those guys truly believed the message and went out there and did the work. But we got great looks in that third quarter. We got great looks in that first quarter. I think our shoulders were up by our ears. We were just a little tense, and we were trying to just figure out a way to just relax and enjoy the game and get back to the game plan.
Jason, on the first day of camp, you talked about Luka trusting his teammates. What did you think about his decision making in the second half? Not just, you know, when he's the one delivering the assist, but when they're forcing the ball out of his hands.
Yeah, we did talk about that, and he did an incredible job in this series. Knowing that they're going to hit him and take the ball out of his hand. And we've talked about it all season that someone's going to have to make a shot or make a play. And JB, Dorian, Reggie, Spencer, Maxie, DP, did I leave anybody out? They've all made plays at some point in the season for us. And so there's a lot of trust for us. We accomplished something, but now, as you know, in the playoffs, this series is over. Now we have to get ready for Phoenix. Yeah, you know, we were sitting there talking when JB was at the line, And so it's, you know, he did everything to put his team in position to win, and his teammates helped him. And that's what, that's who we are as a Mavs. Luka's going to get a lot of attention. He's one of the top players in the world. But his teammates truly are there to protect him and step up. And they did, you know, this evening in game six on the road, which is a hard place to win in Utah. And we were able to win two games here. So hopefully we can build on that confidence playing on the road. But to accomplish, to win his first series, is not easy. So hopefully that monkey's off his back.
Yeah, Jason. Go ahead. Yeah, Jason, it was 11 years ago tonight that your team in Portland won a playoff first round series. I wondered what you remember about that night and that series, and could this team potentially use this series as a catapult the way that team did?
Well, Tim already made me feel old, that was a long time ago when we won in Portland. I just remember a lot of people didn't think we were going to get out of the first round. It's kind of similar to this situation. You got to play the game on the court, and you know, we found a way to win the series. But this is a special group. They truly believe, small or big, and we're not very big, but they find a way to win, and they have fun doing it. And hopefully this gives us confidence going against the best team in the NBA right now.
Okay, we'll go ahead.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, Jason, I apologize that this question has been asked. I can't hear the questions in the room, but could you tell me what you got out of Brunson not only tonight, but during this entire playoff series?
We got everything we could at JB in this series. To start the series without Luka, and Spencer and JB to carry us until Luka got back, and then to be able to play, you know, with Luka as he has done all season. He was big for us on both ends. But the defensive end, we take a lot of pride in. Again, we talked about it in the locker room just a few minutes ago. We held him to under 100 points, you know, and this is one, if not, this is the best NBA, the best offensive team in the NBA. Again, everybody has participated, but JB was great. Luka was great. Everybody was great. Reggie and Dorian won't get a lot of praise, but what they did, you know, playing 45 and 46 minutes a night, you know, that takes a special player in person, and they did that for us in this series.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.